Goldfinger. He's the man with the NASA touch. Magnetic touch. Such a cold finger. To enter his weather of sin. Don't get sucked in. Black carbon dust he'll dump in a field.
For a golden girl knows when he's kissed.
It's the kiss of death
from Mr. Goldfinger. Pretty girl, beware.
That's right. And now, Homeland Security is now involved with our weather and hurricanes. What is Homeland Security up to now? They're the jack of all trades. Immigration, FEMA, and when they aren't too busy spying on all of us, they are now controlling our weather. That's right. In this video, I'm going to show how hurricane intensification and steering has actually been going on since 1947, so it's clearly not a conspiracy by any means. But wow, give it up for Homeland Security. They ought to be on the cover of Time Magazine's Corporation Businessman of the Year, huh? Let's go to our first article. I gathered several articles and a couple of videos on the subject. Busting them. Here's our first article. Get them, Donna. In our first article, titled Department of Homeland Security, Chemtrails and Operation HAMP, which is similar to HARP and may be a connection. But let's be clear. Homeland Security is in the business of aerosol geoengineering to modify hurricanes with a full knowledge of all agencies. It's no secret that Homeland Security purchased millions of bullets, according to this video, for their guns, probably because the word is out they are doing this geoengineering as a weapon and not as a mitigation. Get them, Dono. See our second article, titled New $4 Billion Department of Homeland Security Headquarters. That's right, $4 billion budget. Continue to get funded. 4.5 in the new headquarters they want to open in DC. It's a 4.5 million square foot facility with 14,000 employees. They want to renovate a building that used to be a former insane asylum. Oh, what poetic justice. It's a consolidation of 22 different divisions. Basically, Homeland Security's reason for this new building is they are just having a hard time having and coordinating meetings. So now, hopefully, with this new $4 billion building, they can now have meetings. Yeah, I guess squeezing those 14,000 employees into a, you know, you need a lot of space for that. They've had $800 billion since 9/11, with fusion centers in Utah, with the average salary of a Homeland Security personnel is between $70,000 and $100,000 a year. Well, you do the math on that, folks. Actually, I did. I did it longhand, even. I believe I come up with that 980 million dollars a year of your tax money, because Homeland Security thinks that they need to protect you from the weather. In our, get them, Donna. In our third article, Nemo Blizzard. This is from Veterans Today. Nemo Blizzard, a product of Homeland Security Aerosol Geoengineering Program. HAMP, there it is again. Personally, I think it ought to be thrown in the hamper. But then that's just me. License to Kill. This is an appropriate song. More ways than one. Let's go on to this article here. Nemo. It is. What was questionable were the strategies, but the most disturbing is the deployment of black carbon aerosols to intensify hurricanes by Homeland Security. Two references of deployment of black carbon are found in a report. In 2008, Department of Homeland Security received $64 million to test the effect of aerosol geoengineering on hurricanes. In October of 2012, InfoWars writer Melissa Melton wrote, citing Hurricane Katrina as the basis for their project. The Hurricane Aerosol and Microphysics Program, called HAMP, worked with Project Storm Fury veteran Joe Golden and a panel of other experts to test the effects of aerosols on instruments' intensity of hurricanes. Save goes on to say that evidence is too strong that Frankenstein Sandy Hurricane and now Nemo Blizzard were created by Department of Homeland Security as deliberate weapons of mass destruction and climate terrorism. This all comes down to one motive, and this kind of ties into what Truth by Grace was finally summing up the motive for all this hurricane stuff was, which I didn't really buy at first, but here it is in this article where they wrote, it comes down to the motive to persuade voters as the globalist carbon tax and climate change agenda come up for a vote. So how ironic is it that research from Jason Box, a glaciologist, has identified soot, black carbon, emitted from wildfires, etc., as cause of polar ice melts. In his paper, Bounding the Role of Black Carbon in Climate Systems, Box concludes that soot can melt Greenland's ice caps faster than methane. So I say, in effect, therefore, the globalists themselves are perhaps responsible for this global warming, if any? Let's go on to this article. This was the best one of all that I found. Aircrap.org. How appropriate. Let's see. I want to hear now. Play some garbage. Here we go. Little music. There are news articles. Aircrap.org. Monitoring the planned poisoning of humanity. Let's go down. And this was interesting. In 2009, Richard Spinrad from NOAA's association, he was assistant administrator for OAR, Office of Oceanic and Atmospheric Research. He sent the previous Department of Homeland Security program manager, William Laska, an official memorandum regarding OAR's review of a statement for work for HAMP. Spinrad from NOAA wrote, he wrote, while OAR recognizes that weather modification in general is occurring through the funding of private enterprises, NOAA does not support research that entails efforts to modify hurricanes. Spinrad went on, any collaboration with DHS must occur within NOAA's mission, which NOAA felt HAMP did not do. However, which is the National Hurricane Center, the primary U.S. organization research for tracking and predicting hurricanes. NOAA, you know, you've heard about them for years. Well, their recent budget cuts are expected to hit NOAA's satellite program by $182 million. And meanwhile, Department of Homeland Security was turned down by NOAA, but DHS moved ahead with their little research without NOAA's permission. DHS HAMP overview proposed hypothesis testing. Let's scroll down to this. There's four really good videos. Here's the first one. It was a So they said that seeding with small aerosols suppressing warm rain, seeding with radiation absorbing aerosols at storm periphery, seeding with radiation absorbing aerosols at storm top, pumping cool water to ocean surface in front of hurricane. Carbon black, they found, could increase hurricane intensity. This idea goes back to Gunn and Phillips from 1957 in Journal of Atmospheric Sciences 14, page 272 through 280, where they looked at air pollution affecting rain or in causing rain clouds. They found aerosols can increase floods or decrease rain. So in video, DHS Hurricane Aerosol Microphysics HAMP Weather Modification, it was a conference they had in 2010 here. Let's go ahead and play this clip here. Let's go ahead and play this. I'm going to get back to the video. Okay, it's towards the very end.
Subscribe to you and
here he is.
About which this session is dedicated.
Let's go back to work.
In both the weakening as
here it is.
Hurricane Katrina.
Here it is. Okay. Listen.
So both of these independent results suggested that aerosols could play a very important role in both the weakening as of Hurricane Katrina.
Right. He was about to say both the weakening and strengthening of Hurricane Katrina, but he stopped himself. Coming from the same organization, so he started to say aerosols can affect the way both, I mean, he's going to try two things, weakening and he cuts himself off. He didn't want to say strengthening. Coming down to the same organization that holds symposiums on steering hurricanes. The Hurricane Modification Workshop, initiated under Secretary Jay Cohen, media, oh, yeah, so here's a really interesting, if we go down to their next video, that was a symposium they were at, a workshops they do. And here we go. This is really revealing right here. The real reason weather is manipulated. The real reason weather is manipulated. Okay. Truth Stream Media by Melissa Melton. Kurt Vonnegut had a book called Cat's Cradle. Vonnegut's older brother had worked at General Electric with a scientist named Langmuir. That's his picture right there, I guess. He describes him as a mad scientist in his book called Honecker, in his book Cat's Cradle. Both worked on Project Cirrus, where, this was back in the 1940s, they sprayed silver iodide into a hurricane. Kurt worked there too. I guess his brother got him a job, and he quit after writing a critical column about the company. But the eccentric man, Lansmuir, in 1947, General Electric, the Naval Research, Office of Naval Research, the Air Force, U.S. Weather Bureau, and U.S. Army Signal Corps did an experiment in 1947 where they put silver iodide into a hurricane to maximize the hurricane. It was a couple of days out from sea in the Atlantic, and it changed the direction and it accelerated it and crashed. The hurricane crashed into Savannah, Georgia, with a whole lot of damage. The public was furious. There were lawsuits. The DOD became defensive, and there was a 13-year moratorium was put on weather modification. And key players went back to the drawing board. Now, that you hear, that was a 13-year moratorium. In 1955, Langmuir was still doing research and talking about using weather for war way before his moratorium was over. His cloud seeding in New Mexico resulted in Missouri Valley floods. Operation Popeye was in Vietnam. They had a thing called Operation Popeye, where 2,600 cloud seeding operations, sorties, and they expended 47,000 silver iodide flares over 5 years at an annual cost of $3.6 million a year. Nobody knew about it except the president, a few people. In 1973, Congress found out about it, and the Senate formed a resolution prohibiting the use of environmental or geophysical things as a weapon of war. Up until now, it's like no one's heard of it. In 1997, in a conference on terrorism, weapons, and mass destruction, U.S. strategy to William Cohen said, others are engaging in eco-type terrorism, whereby they can alter climate, set off earthquakes, volcanoes remotely through use of electromagnetic waves. From a news transcript, it was a U.S. Department of Defense type of meeting. And finally, in this video, and I'm going to go ahead and play the whole video because it's really short. This is one of the best ones I've seen, where you can really see clearly how this Hurricane Florence 9/6/2018 was manipulated. And I'm just going to play this clip here.
So this is Tropical Storm Florence on Thursday afternoon, September 6, 2018. It was reported that Florence was downgraded from a 120-mile-an-hour hurricane to a tropical storm due to shearing conditions. But longer forecasts say it's likely to intensify in the days to come. So let's look for clues.